Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. And today I'm going to be doing another review of the Chevrolet Suburban, but instead I'm going to go quicker and I'm going to demonstrate the top 10 features I love that are awesome, that are cool, that are weird. And then I'm going to show you three things, or demonstrate three things that I honestly think is a bummer that this car has. Because as I said in my review, if you hadn't seen it, I'll link it in the description. This car is actually pretty good. It's one of my favorite cars. And it's a bummer that there are really three things that that this car has that it's a bummer, actually. And for the review, I'm just gonna give you a quick note. The audio, my mic screwed up a little bit in that video, so the beginning is a little rough, but it's just the beginning, and then the audio is really good once you finish the intro. So just wanted to give you a quick heads up about that. So with that said, let's get started. Now, in my opinion, one of the first best features about this car, and it's not a feature that everybody, that most of the car manufacturers have included, but it's a heads-up display. Now, this heads-up display is really, really good. You can actually move it up and down. You can change the information that is displayed. You can have your RPMs. You can have just the speed. I would have the radio, but it's currently off. And you have your compass, and it's really a great feature that I think most car manufacturers that haven't done it yet should do, because you don't take your eye off the road as much because you have it directly in your line of view. One of the other features is right here near the screen. As you see, you know, you have your typical buttons and your screen, but there's something special about this screen. You can actually, by clicking the button right here, and oh, you have a secret compartment right here. It's kind of cool. You can put stuff in here. It's kind of deep. It's really, really, it's a secret compartment. So, you know, you can hide your wallet. You can hide something that you don't want people to see. And, you know, after that, you re-push the button. And it goes right back down. The screen turns on again. And there you go. Another great thing about this car is, well, this is a huge car made for a family. And what's great about it is that you have three rows. So you have three rows, and you know, you constantly, you could have a whole family in here and they'll be fitting comfortably. This is one of the only cars that when you're sitting in the third row, you're extremely comfortable. So you basically have these two screens that you can actually watch something. And I mean, not a lot of cars actually have two rear entertainment screens. Another cool thing about this car is, I don't know if you see in the left corner under the temperature, it says Wi-Fi 4G LTE. Well, this car actually comes integrated with OnStar 4G integrated Wi-Fi. So you can be cruising along in the middle of nowhere and still be playing video games online with your friends. That's pretty cool. All right, so now let's talk about something I absolutely love, and those are the 22-inch optional chrome wheels. Look at these things. They make the car look so much better. It just gives a style to the car that I can't quite explain. But I just love those wheels. Don't you guys think this car looks like an FBI car straight out of their movie? Maybe its size, I don't know, and its looks. But yes, they use this. I don't know if I've been watching too much Jason Bourne, but yeah, this is what they use in those movies, which is kind of cool. Actually attracts a lot of attention. But this is where I'm going at. I love the look of this truck. More than the Denali, more than the Escalade. I just love it. The Chevy black badge, the chrome finishes, this hook right here, the beautiful chrome wheels, and the size of it, it's intimidating. And I mean, it really is intimidating, and you really feel safe in this car. This car weighs 5,800 pounds. This is a big vehicle, so it stays on the road extremely well, even though it's high up, and you think it would drag with the wind. But since it's heavy, it tends to lower its center of gravity. But you know, of course, it's extremely slow, with only 355 horsepower, which, by the way, is one of the reasons why I'm not that much of a fan anymore of this beautiful truck. A cool feature that most of you probably don't know is about this truck. When you hold down the lock button, look at the mirrors. The mirrors close automatically. Since principle, when you unlock the truck, you press the unlock button and... So it's pretty cool. Let's just say you're in a tight spot, especially with this thing, you will be in a tight spot. And you forgot to shut it off in the car itself. Instead of going back, all you have to do is hold the buttons on the key fob and, you know, job well done. Lastly, let's talk about the liftgate. The liftgate, which is cool, is, let's just say you don't want to open the whole door, you don't have enough room, I don't know, for some reason. Well, either with the key fob or with the little button right under the Chevy badge, which I can't find, there we go, you can pop the rear window, which is kind of cool. So you can access the trunk without opening the entire liftgate. But, I mean, nothing stops you from opening it. Press it twice, and there you go. You open it. And you still have a decent trunk, even with the third row. So this is the last, is right here. You have a few switches. This is your drivetrain, your drive modes, actually, not like sport or off-roading, but more like the wheels that are active. So right now it's in two high, which means that only the rear wheels are active. Then you have auto. Then you have four high. So four high is actually you're constantly driving on four wheels. And then you have four low. Four low actually is, you know, it's more of an off-roading type of thing. Now, unfortunately, my mic for my recorder when I'm driving just didn't work while I was filming this part. And unfortunately, I will have to do a voiceover for this part. So what I say in this part is basically my three things that I personally don't really like about the car, and which I think it's a huge bummer. So the first thing is the price. Now, a Chevrolet Suburban in American dollars is around $65,000. Pretty pricey. And this one, as equipped, was around $65,500. And now a fully equipped Denali, a Yukon, which is a slightly better in terms of interior quality and the engine, is $67,000. The Suburban doesn't have the 6.2 liter V8 that produces 420 horsepower like the Denali has. Actually, the Suburban has a 355 horsepower 5.3 liter V8. And I mean, these cars have $1,500 difference in pricing, and yet one has a way bigger engine than the other. And I'm surprised that a engine with nearly 100 horsepower more is $1,500 more than the one without it. I don't think an engine is a $1,500 option, which is why I don't understand why they don't pull in the Chevrolet. The price are nearly identical, and yet the engines are not. And that is really something that I don't understand. So that's a number one and number two combined. And then I'm going to go with number three. Basically, the infotainment system. The infotainment system is extremely laggy. As you see on the screen, I'm messing around with it and it's not working. It's taking a long time to respond. And, you know, it's slow. And I know I'm messing around with it, but still, it shouldn't be this slow. And also with the Apple CarPlay, as you see right now, I'm plugging in my phone and I'm clicking projection many times, as you'll see right now, and yet it doesn't respond. And it's really weird. The system is so slow. This is a 2017 model car, and the computer works like if it were in a 2010, which shouldn't be the case at all. And I heard that in the Sierra now, they completely redesigned it. It's way better. And that's great. But unfortunately, this being a 2017, it is stuck with the old version of the system. But anyways, those are the three things I really don't like about this Chevy Suburban. So there you have it. The top 10 things I love about this car, and the top 10 three things that I do not like about this car. This car is a great car overall, but you know, you have the disappointment of not having the big engine. I mean, and also, I like the looks more of this car. $1,000 less than the Denali Yukon XL. And the Denali XL we have, you have a slightly better interior and you have a way bigger engine. which is kind of disappointing. I am really disappointed that you can't get these things in the Suburban, even though it's the same price. And now that is really my big issue with this car. But with that said, guys, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to leave a comment if you're interested. If you have any more questions about this car, leave a like because it helps a bunch. Subscribe to the channel if you are new, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care, guys.